spoken over this last number of months to many people involved in the Irish music industry, singers, musicians, artists, etc. And I'm delighted to say hello to a wandering Wicklow boy who has been wandering around numerous countless halls and dance halls and places of dancing, music and entertainment for many, many moons. Based in Manchester, I'm delighted to say hello to Pat Jordan. Pat, how are you?
I'm good, Gerry. And yourself?
Yeah, not too bad at all. Not too bad. Surviving in these strange times, Pat.
Strange times indeed, Gerry. That's for sure.
Indeed. Pat, you've been involved in music for a long, long time at this stage.
Gerry, we're just talking to someone about it the other day, to tell you the truth. 50 years now, not with the same band, but actually the band I'm with, my Finney and Rainbow, we've been on the road about 43 years this year.
Wow.
But yeah, 50 years now in the music business.
That is phenomenal, Pat. That really is. That's a truly, truly incredible, record to be involved in an industry that's in so many ways, notorious for having short stays in it. Since you started, there's many, many people have come and gone in various music genres.
Oh, absolutely. And the amount of great friends in the music business as well that was going when the music scene was very big, the show band scene and what have you. People like a good friend of mine, the late Johnny Lockery, God rest him, and lots and lots of people like that, I've seen come and go, and we're still holding our own, but God knows, Gerry, when we'll play music again live with this COVID-19 going on.
Indeed, so it certainly put the kibosh on music and entertainment. Everything, in fact, really, Pat, to do with the arts or any live type of performance of anything. It has just absolutely destroyed it. Not alone, in Ireland or England or Europe, but completely worldwide.
All worldwide, Gerry, and I think it'll be the last thing to come back as well, because it's not people don't see it as a priority, You only miss it when you haven't got it, but it's a difficult one,
Indeed so, indeed so. That's the thing, and unfortunately, the experts all say that the likes of pubs, clubs, theatres, dance halls, places like that, are the worst, singularly the worst place for catching COVID. So it's not exactly looking too bright at the moment.
Not too bright. I think, Gerry, we would tell you the truth. I can't see anything happen until they find a vaccine, because people are not going to go out and put themselves in vulnerable positions. And I certainly wouldn't be in a hurry to rush out myself and get on stage and put myself in a vulnerable position either,
Indeed so, indeed so. Or and the other thing as well is you you don't want to be in a vulnerable position, and it's not fair to want other people to put themselves in vulnerable positions either.
No, very true, Gerry. Yeah, absolutely.
Pat, you've recorded an amazing amount of material all over the years.
I have, Gerry. I've some like 12 CDs out, to tell you the truth. At the moment, I think it's 12, and could be maybe even more, but anyway, I think around 12, 13, something like that.
That's a pretty impressive at this stage, it really is. And you've recorded a lot of songs, and you've got they've proven very, very popular all over the years. You put your own slat on many of the songs, your own style with them, and it really has gone down a storm.
Oh yeah, we've been lucky, and I'm lucky to bite in the band as well that I've got, because they've been with me many, many years. We've been together a long, long time. Yeah.
A song which went extremely well for you was one you recorded on Turn Wine Back Into Water, and was the song The Wandering Wicklow Woman.
I had one on it called the Wandering Wicklow Man.
Oh, the Wandering.
And then I had Wicklow Girl was the big one.
Yes.
My Wicklow Girl, that's a nice song as well, yeah.
Indeed, that's what, they went extremely well, because they're really, for some reason, there aren't that many songs from Wicklow.
Not really, no, among the Wicklow Hills, I suppose, and, few and far between,
Indeed, so they went very, very well, of course. You've been a native son of Wicklow, nice to record a song from back home.
Yeah, oh yes, indeed.
Pat, you were busy and you were performing away and everything was going well until the lockdown.
Just we had a huge year ahead of us. To tell you the truth, I was lucky because I'd been in Portugal when this thing broke in China, and I was listening to it on the news, never suspecting that we would finish up with it in Europe and the UK and Ireland, whatever. And I was there, and I was in Portugal there in February, you know. Gee, we just made it back, and then things started to change rapidly. And then we had a weekend in Blackpool, Jerry, on the same, you know, prior to St. Patrick's. Of course, St. Patrick, and we were lucky to get away with it because it just had kicked in then, and the hotel was very diligent with hand washing and cleanliness and everything else. And just we got back to Manchester here on the Monday the 15th, and that Monday night everyone went on lockdown.
Indeed, that was so speaking to some of the other people who were at that event in Blackpool on that weekend, and that was the last weekend they actually performed. Nothing whatsoever since, you know. And but Pat, listen, you've been keeping yourself busy. Every Sunday you're doing a Facebook Live.
I'm doing a Facebook Live every Sunday, Jerry, but I'll tell you what I've turned my hand to, and I've never done it before, and if you go on my Facebook page, you will probably see it. I've turned my hand to, and I'm not a joiner, I've never would work in my life. I'm making wishing wells, planters, I'm making all the guys, all garden stuff, I'm making butterflies, I'm making wishing wells, I'm making planters, I'm making bird houses. And my latest one is, you know, we have the Manchester, I Love Manchester Bee, you know, from the time of the bomb the arena here with the young girls in it, you know?
Yes.
And there's a tribute to him, and it's a bee, Manchester. Well, I just created, funny enough, one of those today, the Manchester Bee.
That is magic.
Yeah, it's...
I see on them.
Keep myself occupied, Jerry. Yeah.
Indeed, Pat. I'll tell you, they. I'm looking at them now here on Facebook, and they really, really look impressive. It's actually hard to believe that you didn't. You're not actually a joiner.
Not at all. I've never done woodwork. I tell you how it happened. I was here for. I'd like to say we went to lockdown on the 15th, and then of course St. Patrick's Night and everything was cancelled, and then by the 18th, I thought you can only watch so much TV, you know. And on the 18th, I went out to clean my shed. And I found a bit of old wood, and I thought, I think I'll make a birdhouse. That's how it started. I made a birdhouse first.
Wow.
And then I got this idea then from a friend of mine. He said, why don't you make a planter? You know, planters are very popular. So then I made a bit of more wood, and I made a planter. And then developed from there, and then I had a big piece of ply, and I decided to sketch out a butterfly. It's 18 inches by 14 inches. And you might, you know, them on there. They're all different colors. And they're doing them in pink for girls and blue for boys. And they're hugely popular. And then I do yellow and orange and, oh, Jesus, all sorts of colors on the butterflies, yeah.
Absolutely brilliant. Fantastic stuff. And well done. It's the start of a complete other industry, Pat, for you.
Indeed, yeah.
Indeed, fair play. Well done. That's absolutely excellent. I can see from the background that there's obviously not a lot more you can do with the garden. It's looking good. So you've got to be doing something else, because I know that many of the singers I've been talking to have taken up gardening in a big way.
Yeah,
well, you didn't have to do a huge honor, because the garden, as I say, is looking well. So fair play on doing that. You must miss Pat after all these years. You must miss meeting the people out at the dances.
Absolutely, Jerry. That's the biggest thing. I mean, I love the playing, traveling bit. I was never a great fan of traveling miles, but it had to be done. But my biggest kick was sending people home at the end of the night feeling happy and knowing that they enjoyed themselves, you know.
Indeed, it's great, and it's lovely to when you're out and about in places to meet all the people and to see them, and to all of that sort of to be suddenly gone at this stage is something else.
Oh, I know, yeah, it is. It's a desperate feeling, you know, and a lot of people. That was the only enjoyment I got, you know, just getting out for a few. I've retired from the day job as well. I was doing, you know, the afternoon tea dances, on my own, not with the band, just on my own. And I was busy with places like Halifax and Liverpool and Birkenhead and Manchester, you know, Irish Community Care and what have you. And people love getting out, and of course they're all missing that now, you know.
Indeed, indeed. So many people, you know, that who have been in contact with, many people who, you know, message me in here on the programs, say about that. You know, this is the same for. I mean, I get the same feedback from a huge amount of people in Ireland in the same position. You know, who really, really do miss going out and the socialising and all the rest of it. And unfortunately, at this stage, with the problem is that's exactly what people miss, and that's exactly the thing which is the problem and cause you harm. So it's a no.
Of course, I think probably one of your many listeners is probably a couple that you probably know. It's Maura and Tom Deniff.
Indeed, yes.
I know Tom is always sending me your links to your radio show and what have you, but they're listening to me every Sunday. Tom, I think, is from Kilkenny, and Maura is from Donegal, and they live down in East London somewhere, you know.
Yes.
But they used to. They're telling me about were tea dances and things like that all the time, you know.
That's right. That's right, indeed. And it's you know, the whole thing is a complete and utter, you know, complete and utter change in habits and change in everything. You know,
that's right.
That's just a pattern of fortune. That's you know, that is the way it is. And there's not a major amount we can do about it at this stage.
Not a thing we can do about it, Jerry. But as long as we keep our health, and that's the main thing, you know.
Indeed so. Indeed so. It's a case.
Strange old times, Jerry.
Indeed, Pat. Pat, listen, it's been lovely, lovely to catch up with you again. I wish you every success. Well done on the work with the wood, and also keep going with the Sunday afternoons live on Facebook. Sounding good, they are. Very well presented.
Yeah. And 8 o'clock, if any of you listen, 8 o'clock. I do a live stream 8 o'clock on a Sunday evening.
8 o'clock.
For about an hour and a half, you know.
Great stuff. Pat, yeah. Lovely to catch up with you again. Thanks very much.
Jerry, thanks very much for the interview. And say a big hello to all our friends in London and surrounding areas that listen to your show. And keep safe and mind yourselves.